Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. Hope you are all well. So for today's video, I actually wanted to test a bunch of the products I have recently gotten from Sephora. These are products that are like super hyped right now, so I thought it'd be fun to just do that. And I'm actually getting ready, so this won't be a really get ready with me situation, or it might be, I guess, but I just wanted to test out these products. And I have another one coming very soon for you guys with very popular makeup that is very inexpensive, so look forward to that. So I'm just gonna go ahead and get started. I'll let you guys know what I got. I did get the new Makeup Forever foundation, but I'm not gonna use that today because I wanna do a wear test with that. So I'm gonna be testing the Danessa Myricks Yummy Foundation, Yummy Skin Serum Foundation. This looks like it's right up my alley. I got two concealers. I got the KOSAS Revealer Concealer, which is really popular, and the Liss Triple Fix. These are both super hyped right now, so I wanted to try them out. I also got the HUDA Beauty Pound Cake Powder. So we're gonna go ahead and do that today. So hopefully you'll find this as fun as I will testing all these products. So I hope you enjoy, and let's just go ahead and get started. So first I'm just gonna go ahead and conceal and prime my eyelids. I'm actually not using LA Girl for once. And that's just because I've been noticing it's a little too dark for me right now. So I feel like my eyelids look extra dark, which I don't like particularly. Maybe in the summer it'll be more fitting. But I feel like I'm just at my fairest right now, so it's not looking the best. So I'm using a lighter shade of a concealer I don't use under my eyes a lot. So I'm gonna go ahead and blend that on our lids. I have you guys zoomed in a little more so you're able to see. I'm also testing the liquid eyeshadow. I actually got this off Fashion Nova's website, but it's called Maven Beauty, and these are the Asteroid Tears. This is in the shade Supermoon, so I'm going to be testing this out. I've been really into liquid products recently, like liquid blushes, liquid eyeshadows, liquid everything. I just love. So I'm going to go ahead and take my Patrick Star One Size palette, and I'm just going to take the shade Mango, which is right here. And I am just making sure that I'm in focus, unlike last time. I'm so sorry you guys had to watch me going out of focus the whole time. But I have ordered a backdrop and we'll see how that goes. My issue is that I don't have a lot of room here. Like my room, like four corners of it are already stuffed with all my stuff. And I don't have as much space. So I'm not sure how I'm going to manage having the backdrop. But I know it'll help because I don't have to worry about focusing issues like last time. And then next I'm gonna take the shade Soft Serve, which is that one there. And I'm just taking a little bit of that, just tapping my brush in, and I'm just gonna blend that right on top what I did. Oh, this brush is shedding. It's probably bye-bye now. But just gonna blend that out. Okay, now I'm going to go ahead and take the eyeshadow. This is the Maven Beauty Asteroid Tears. I'm just gonna go ahead and shake this up. So it reminded me of the Stila eyeshadows that we used to have. I'm just gonna swatch this for you guys so you can see. I'm gonna grab a brush like this just in case, just to like lay it out so there's no harsh lines. So I'm just applying it all over my lid, and then I'm taking this brush and I'm just patting it in. Just try not to swipe because I feel like that does lift this eyeshadow and it doesn't apply as pigmented if you're swiping it. Also, as soon as this dries, it's dried and it's really hard to move this around, so just keep that in mind. And the reason I've been enjoying liquid eyeshadows as of lately, or like gel eyeshadows, I feel like they're so effortless. Like I feel like if you have this on, it looks like you put so much work into your makeup when you really didn't. And I'm all about that life. So yeah, it's super pretty. I love the color. Now I'm noticing this one's a little more extreme, so I'm just gonna go ahead and apply a little more just so we're matching here. Okay, and we're gonna go ahead and dab that on as well. Okay, there we go. I'm gonna have to brush like this now. This is the e.l.f. Blending brush, and I'm gonna go back to my Patrick Star palette, and I'm gonna take the shade Mango again, just to soften out the edges. So just took a little bit here and I'm just gonna go ahead and apply that to the edges here. Now, just to make this a little more dramatic, I'm taking the shade Booked and I'm taking a little bit because this stuff is pigmented, and we're just gonna go ahead and apply that in the outer corner like so. Doing the same on the other eye, And we're gonna go ahead and blend into the outer corner. Now I'm just cleaning off the brush. I have a little towel here and I'm just taking whatever's excess and I'm just blending that in like so. Okay, and at this time, if you decide you want to go ahead and touch up the eyeshadow, you can. Okay, you guys, I know this probably looks really crazy, but just have faith in me. Next, I'm taking Ardell, and these are Demi Wispies. Oops, just to show you guys. They're super natural lashes, but I like them. They look really nice and I'm just really into natural lashes right now. So I'm gonna go ahead and apply these. Okay, I can never put my lashes on camera, you guys, maybe one day, but today's not the day. So now I'm just gonna go ahead and work on my face. So I'm taking the Too Faced Hangover RX primer, just dabbing that in here and using a lot of this. And I'm taking my ColourPop F4 stippling brush to blend this all in. I'm just gonna grab a little more. I want to feel properly primed. So, one of the biggest ways to actually prevent cakiness is to properly prime or prime. I know some people skip primer, which I can't believe. I could never skip primer. Even if I'm like always doing like everyday makeup, I just think makeup just applies better with primer. So yeah, I don't know. Personal preference, I guess, but I just love primer. So it's like an extra layer of hydration for me since I am dry. Anyways, we're gonna go ahead and go in with the foundation. Now, I have two shades of this and I think I'm returning one because I don't think I need both of them. I just have issues with Sephora foundations, you guys know. So I have 6N and 4N. And 4N I know is already way too light, so I'm gonna go ahead and probably keep 6N. If I need to mix some of 4N into here, I will do so. So I like this because you can also buy refills of this. So I think that's super genius that you can buy refills and like just replace them instead of buying a whole bottle all over again. So I'm just gonna read a little bit of the info here. Again, this is the Danessa Myricks Yummy Skin Serum Foundation, and it says it's a skin-loving skincare hybrid foundation with medium buildable coverage, formulated with ingredients known to provide antioxidant boost, balance hydration and moisture. And it says on here to shake and squeeze out a pea-sized amount for even smooth coverage. And it says it's refillable, refill sold separately, obviously. So we're gonna go ahead and apply this. Now I'm using the sponge I got from Shoppers. Oh, before I do that, I am out of it, clearly. I'm gonna go ahead and color correct. Using Visanti VO2, and I'm just using the e.l.f. Camo, this is the e.l.f. Blending Perfector. It came in a set with the Camo sponge, which I will also be using today, so. Okay. So I'm gonna go in with my sponge. Now this is the shade 6N, and it looks like it's a good match. It's a little bit smidgen dark, but I think I can make it work once I have powders on, because the 4 was definitely way too light for me. So yeah, looks like I have a foundation beard right now. So I'm just applying this on, and we are blending it into the forehead. Okay, so first impression, this is very lightweight. Like, it feels lightweight. Coverage is definitely not lightweight. I would say it's medium right now. And I like that it looks very hydrating. My skin doesn't look dry yet. And it smells like really... Is that the smell of this or the foundation? I mean, the brush, because I might have just washed my brush with... Oh no, it's this. It's very light smelling. It smells like skincare. So okay, so that's one layer. And I have a little bit more on my mixing palette here, so I'm just gonna go ahead and concentrate that on areas where I need a little more coverage. So my forehead, where my friend has visited, decided to stay for a while. I'm gonna go ahead and spray my Charlotte Tilbury Airbrush Flawless Setting Spray. I need this makeup to last all night, you guys, because I am getting ready like 3 hours before I'm supposed to be anywhere, so I'd like this makeup to last. So I'm gonna go ahead and spritz this on. So I have the foundation on to a medium coverage right now. It is definitely not full. I can see some of my blemishes, but I'm going to keep the foundation as is. I think once I have concealer and powders, I feel like it'll just go all together. And we're gonna go ahead and work on our brows. I am using the e.l.f. Instant Brow Lift Pencil. Okay, I hope I was in focus. Let's hope I have focusing issues with this video, because I will not be happy. I know it's like not ideal for me to be filming in front of something that the camera could focus off of, but I have to be in front of the window. Like if I go in another direction, I'm not gonna have natural lighting, and I just prefer to film with natural lighting. Just having artificial lighting does not look the best when you're doing makeup application, to be honest, but like worst comes to worst, I'll probably will have to just shift around or something. So yeah, just considering that in case I have to, but for now, this is where I like to film. Brows are done. I'm gonna go ahead and get my Essence Lash and Brow Gel. Just gonna run that through my brows. So now that the brows are done, we are going to move on to concealer, which I am so nervous about because this could ruin my whole makeup situation. So I have two concealers. Like I said, these are so hyped right now on the internet. This is the LYS Triple Fix, and I got this in the shade LN06, which now that I'm seeing it might be a little bit... actually, the shade's not that bad. Okay, this brush is so hard to put back in. Okay, so I got that in the shade LN06, and I also have the KOSAS Revealer Super Creamy and Brightening 03W. So we're going to swatch that too right next to it. I could use a mix of both, to be honest, but yeah. So that's the KOSAS, and that's the list. So okay, I'm gonna go ahead and apply the list first, just to see how this goes. Okay, I don't like how hard it is to take this out. I'm going to apply it right here. Worst comes to worst, if I like the formula, I will definitely just get another shade. I'm very bad at picking out shades lately. Like, seriously, what is going on? Okay, we're going to start off with a little bit because I have no idea what kind of coverage this has. So, I'm going to take my e.l.f. Camo sponge, and I'm just blending this in. Okay, so that's what one layer of coverage gave. It's definitely not bad. Like medium coverage, I would say. Okay, so we're gonna go ahead and do that to the other eye, and then I'm gonna put the KOSAS right on top. Oops. So, applying this. I think the shade could do with a color change, but I'm just trying to keep in mind that once the summer changes, I feel like I'll just have to buy this again. So maybe I'll keep it, or we'll see. Maybe with the powder that I bought, it's gonna balance it out. So we'll see. Okay, so that looks really pretty, I'm not gonna lie, but I definitely prefer more coverage personally because I have dark circles. So I'm gonna go in with the KOSAS concealer, and I'm gonna apply a little bit right here. This is a little bit for me, you guys remember what I said. Okay, not a little bit anymore. Okay, I'm gonna go back in with my sponge. Okay. Okay. definitely think I like the KOSAS concealer better so far. It's super hydrating. Like, it has the hydrating properties as the Anastasia Magic Touch concealer, but I would say that the Anastasia probably provides a little bit more coverage, but this like feels amazing under the eyes. Like, it's super hydrating, it's super creamy, like super easy to work with. Okay, so we're gonna go ahead and move on to the powder. Now, the powder I got is something I'm super late to. I'm pretty sure everyone and their mommy has this powder, but I'm last to it, and that is the Huda Beauty, what is this called? It's just called the Huda Beauty powder. Easy bake, loose baking, and setting powder. I got the shade Pound Cake, and I'm so excited to use this. So we're gonna go ahead and use this to set our under eyes. Might even use it to set my face, I think, but let me just see how this goes. So I already opened this, you guys, just letting you know. So I'm gonna go ahead and just blend out my concealer. I know that Huda Beauty came out with the a pink version of this powder recently. I don't know how that would look on me because I'm not, you know, fair, but I wanted to get into trying these. So I'm using my sponge to apply this. I am just not pressing in too hard because I don't want it to lift any concealer, but close to like baking, but not really because I'm not going to sweep any of this away. But wow, okay. It definitely brightened up. Like, I don't know if you guys can see a difference. You're zoomed in so I can show you the difference. I don't know if you guys can see. This is with powder and that's without. Okay. Very impressive so far, but we're gonna go ahead and keep applying. So I'm gonna blend in this eye. Gonna take the powder again. And just gently dab under the eye. Okay. Oh Lord. There's powder everywhere. Okay. This is definitely brightening. So I want to use this to set the rest of my face. I think that's what we're going to do. So we're going to go ahead and use this to set the rest of our face. I'm taking my Tati Beauty puff here and I'm just going to go ahead and set very lightly. This powder has a scent. I don't know why everything I'm using has a scent suddenly. Nothing perfumey. Hopefully this doesn't irritate anybody's skin. I don't know if you're sensitive, if it would, but it's not irritating me, so just keep that in mind. I know that she has a setting spray that people said that they didn't like because it was fragranced. So sorry, I'm just trying to get it out. Okay. So I really like so far with this powder is it's like super finely milled. It seems to be, ooh, it seems to be like applying very nicely, but it also adds like at the same time of it being finely milled, it's also adding like coverage. So I'm finding that really interesting. So the only places I didn't really apply it on was my cheeks. And that's just because I want to apply a liquid blush or a cream blush, and I don't know if the foundation is going to lift because I have not used this foundation before. So I'm going to go ahead and move on to that. So that is the powder so far. I look like a ghost, but I'm matching, you know, like I'm matching to my neck and stuff. So yeah, we're going to go ahead and apply the ColourPop Cool It Cream Blush. Oops, I am almost out of this. This is all I have left, you guys. So I'm going to go ahead and swipe this on my hand like this. And I'm taking my e.l.f. airbrush stipple and I'm just dabbing that onto my cheeks very lightly because I don't want to lift any of this foundation if that happens, but we'll see. Okay, and I'm just doing the same on the other side. I can't believe I'm almost done this blush. That's crazy to me. So satisfying when you run out of makeup products. Just taking the excess and dabbing it lightly to both cheeks. So I had to fix my scarf because I look a little different, but I just finished applying the blush. Now I'm going to go in with my Amrizi highlighter from Anastasia Beverly Hills. And I'm taking that on my e.l.f. concealer brush. And I am applying this to here. So usually I apply up here, but I noticed that my scarf just ends up covering it, so I don't know why I'm doing that anyways. So depends on how I wear my scarf, but I usually, when I wear it, the way I do it covers this area, so I don't see a point in putting it over there. But yeah, just thought I'd let you know. Applying it on my nose and whatever's remaining on the tip of my nose. Taking a smaller brush to highlight my inner corners. Okay. I almost forgot one of my favorite makeup steps to do, and that's to highlight my brow bone. So I'm gonna go ahead and take the shade Manila Sands from the Patrick Star Palette right there. And I'm just taking this on my brush and applying it to my brow bone. I don't know why I feel like this pulls your makeup together. It's so weird, but I feel like it does. I don't know. It might be crazy. Now we're gonna go ahead and apply the last layer, second layer, last layer of my Charlotte Tilbury Flawless Skin Spray, just so I can lock all this in. I just wiped off my lip balm because I'm gonna go ahead and apply my lipstick. I wiped off majority of it, so I'm gonna go ahead and line my lips. Now, the bottom lip I do like to overline, so I might need to be closer to mirror for this. But this is where my lip line ends, right where I've traced it, and I'm just gonna overline a tiny bit. Sorry, I just realized you guys didn't see what I was doing. Okay. And you still don't see it. Oh my god, I'm so bad. Okay. So, I overlined a little bit on the bottom. Not really, you guys. This is just like where my lip line really ends. It's not really straight right now because... Oh god. Okay. So, I just go over the same area a few times until it goes a little bit outside the border. So, I didn't overline as much. This is where my lips start and end, basically. Now I'm going to take my favorite Etude Dear Darling Water Tint. I'm gonna go ahead and apply this to our lips. I haven't worn this in a few days and I already miss it, like, oh god. Okay. And I like this because it lasts so long. It looks so good. And like, even when it wears off, it doesn't give you that like ring of leftover lipstick that liquid lipsticks do. And it's just, ugh, I love it. It feels amazing. So that is the look that I have done, and so far I have to say everything I've used today is really nice. I really like the foundation. I am definitely not full coverage right now, but I like how healthy my skin looks. The concealers were a hit. I do think the Liss one, I would say between the Liss and the KOSAS, I would definitely go for the KOSAS. I don't know if it's because this is more my shade, but I just feel like this applied so creamy, it blended out beautifully. And the Liss one, I just feel like it's really hard and like difficult to take in and out of the tube, like, if you guys know what I mean. I'm just gonna show you, and every time I do this it like splatters some of it around, so I'm not a fan of that. I don't know why it's like that, but I've heard great things about this concealer. It's definitely not the worst, it's really good, but I think just the shade probably threw me off a little bit. But I think in combination with the KOSAS, it looks really good. The Huda Beauty Powder, I have to say, has wowed me because my under eyes look so bright and they look set, and I'm confident and hoping that this does not make me crease throughout the night. Eyeshadow is a beautiful. I love liquid eyeshadows. I'm going to be traveling this year and I just want to collect as many liquid eyeshadows because I feel like I don't have to take palettes with me. So I really love this. I love how the eye look turned out. You guys have probably seen me do a look like this before, but I love it. It's so flattering. Super universal. I feel like this eye look would just look good on everybody. And I got another shade of this. I actually got it in a blue too, and it is so beautiful. I have not used the blue yet, but I'm really into colorful shadows, as you guys know. So yeah, I have to say everything was a hit, and yeah, I'm definitely enjoying these products. be on the lookout for a new foundation wear test. That's the Makeup Forever New HD foundation. I believe it's been reformulated, and then I'm also waiting on a package from SheGlam, which is Shein's makeup brand, and I will be testing almost the full face of all their makeup, and their makeup's super inexpensive, so hopefully they are good products. So I can't wait to go through that with you guys. I hope you guys enjoyed today's video. Please like, comment, and subscribe, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye!